I am going to introduce polynomial equations based on polynomials. Still there are some more problems related to polynomials and I will discuss further one by one, okay? After dealing with the polynomial equations and at the end I will deal with different problems related to polynomials and polynomial equations. Basically, what is polynomial and what is polynomial equation? Simply, if P of x is a polynomial, if P of x is a polynomial, then P of x is equals to 0. If P of x is a polynomial, then simply P of x is equals to 0 is polynomial equation. Okay, if P of x is a polynomial, then simply P of x is equals to 0 is considered as polynomial equation. That's it. You just take any polynomial and that polynomial is equals to 0 is usually considered as polynomial equation. And see, zeros of, see, suppose alpha, beta, gamma, something, okay, suppose alpha, beta, gamma and something are zeros of polynomial, then those zeros of polynomial are considered as roots of the polynomial equation. Okay, I think you all know it. Suppose alpha, beta, gamma and so on are zeros of the polynomial, then alpha, beta, gamma and so on are roots of polynomial equation. Okay, see, all these things are very obvious actually. So if alpha is a zero of the polynomial, then this mentioned alpha, beta, gamma are roots of the polynomial equation. Okay, and for suppose what I am going to tell you is, for example, if you have simply you just consider a quadratic polynomial, if P of x is equals to x square minus 5x plus 6, and we know the zeros of the polynomial are 2 comma 3. Okay, so when you factorize it, this is x square minus 5x plus 6, then we have a chance to factorize it like x minus 2 into x minus 3. So if P of x is equals to x minus 2 into x minus 3, then we say 2 comma 3 are zeros of P of x. 2 comma 3 are zeros of P of x, or we may say in the same way we will say, okay, also we call 2 comma 3 as roots of polynomial equation P of x is equals to 0. Okay, this is all something, okay, BTA, polynomial, polynomial equation, zeros of the polynomial, roots of the polynomial equation and simple example. Have a look and then I will discuss one important point. Suppose alpha comma beta are zeros of polynomial. Suppose alpha comma beta are zeros of polynomial, then we write that P of x is equals to some x minus alpha into x minus beta into Q of x. X minus alpha into x minus beta into Q of x. They are the zeros, but we are not sure that they are only zeros. So P of x is equals to x minus alpha into x minus beta into Q of x. And if they mention something about the degree of P of x, as per that we will consider that Q of x. Okay, so for suppose, see, this is P of x. If degree of P of x is equals to, you may say anything like 4, if degree of P of x is equals to 4, then we will consider P of x as x minus alpha into x minus beta into, since it is of 4, it may be a second degree equation. So, Ax square plus Bx plus C, like that we need to consider. If degree of p of x is equals to 3, then the polynomial will become like this. Already two factors are there, like x minus alpha and x minus beta. Then we need to think about the third factor, third linear factor. So you may take it as ax plus b. Whereas if degree of p of x is equals to 2, if degree of p of x is equals to 2, then the polynomial p of x is considered as x minus alpha into x minus beta. So this is of second degree, so that q of x may be a some constant. Okay, so if alpha comma beta are the zeros of the polynomial depending on the degree, we will think about all these things. Okay, so in the same way, polynomial equation having alpha comma beta as roots, what we need to write, how we need to write, that's what I am going to tell you. Okay, so now this is about polynomial, and the next thing is, if alpha comma beta are roots of polynomial equation of second degree, are roots of polynomial equation of degree 2 is, see, degree 2, as I mentioned, degree 2, and the roots are alpha beta. Since it is a polynomial of degree 2, then what we say, then simply this is polynomial and this is equals to 0. But while writing it is equals to 0, no need to mention that a. So if alpha comma beta are roots of polynomial equation of degree 2, then simply we will say that x minus alpha into x minus beta is equals to 0. Okay, no need to mention that a here, because you said that it will 0 by that a is 0. So if alpha comma beta are roots of the polynomial equation of degree 2, always our answer is x minus alpha into x minus beta is equals to 0. Whereas if alpha comma beta are zeros of polynomial p of x, then that the polynomial can be written as x minus alpha into x minus beta into a. So in generally, since these are the zeros, these two are the factors, and there may be a third factor. That third factor is dependent on the degree of the polynomial. Okay, but whereas coming to the equation, it is bit different. Okay, have a look. Relation between roots and coefficients. So already we know related to the quadratic, and I will start my discussion with quadratic, and then I extend it for cubic, fourth degree and further. Okay, first of all, a, if alpha comma beta are roots of a quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. See, alpha comma beta are the roots of this particular equation. Okay, right. So if alpha comma beta are the roots of this equation, then we need to establish relations between these roots alpha beta as well as the coefficients a, b, c. Right. So what we need to consider, since alpha beta are the roots of this particular equation, then alpha beta are the zeros of the polynomial, is it right? Then alpha comma beta are zeros of ax square plus bx plus c. This ax square plus bx plus c is a polynomial, okay, and clearly it is of second degree, and from there I will write that ax square plus bx plus c is equals to, since they are the zeros, so x, by factor theorem we are very clear that x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors. Since x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors, as well as the coefficient of x square is a, I will write that a into x minus alpha into x minus beta. Okay, and since it is a into x minus alpha into x minus beta, you just send that a this side, it will become x square plus b by a x plus c by a is equals to, that side if you multiply you will get x square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. And since these two are equal, you just compare the corresponding coefficients, coefficient of x square, coefficient of x, and the constant term. Likewise, if you compare, what will happen? See here the coefficient of x is b by a, and here the coefficient of x is alpha plus beta. So we have that alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a, and the c by a is this, and then product alpha into beta is equals to c by a. Right? This is something about the quadratic equation or the quadratic polynomial related to the zeros. Okay? And then I need to extend this idea for cubic, then for fourth degree, and then we need to generalize for nth degree polynomial also. Okay? Have a look. So at the end, alpha plus beta is minus b by a, alpha into beta is c by a. This alpha plus beta is what? Sum of the roots. The sentence formation is also required. Sum of the roots is minus b by a, product of the roots is c by a. From these two, what I need to establish is, therefore, for a cubic polynomial, sum of roots is equals to minus b by a, in the sense minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square, whereas the product of roots is equals to constant term divided by coefficient of x square. Okay, just have a look. And sometimes, and some books may notate this sum of the roots as s1, because only one term is involved here, right? And it is product of the roots, and they name it, they notate it like s2. This is just a notation, that's it. Okay, this is something about second degree polynomial with two roots. And then I will extend it for third degree and third roots and so on. Okay, have a look. Next, B. If alpha, beta, gamma be the roots of ax cube plus third degree, I am considering now, ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is equals to 0. Since these three are the roots of that in turn represents that alpha, beta, gamma are zeros of the polynomial ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So that is a third degree polynomial, and since these three are the zeros, x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma are the factors by factor theorem. Since these three are the factors, now we have a chance to rewrite ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is equals to, this is of third degree, so it must have only three factors, and already those three factors are clear. And since this coefficient of x cube is a, so I will write it like this: a into x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma. Very simple idea actually. Okay, these three are the factors. Usually if these three are the factors, x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma, we need to write the product into some q of x. Since it is of third degree, that q of x is a constant. Since its coefficient is a, that constant is nothing but just a. Okay, now from this, again as we discussed in the earlier case, divide with a, send that a this side, you will get that x cube plus b by a, x square plus c by a, x plus d by a. This is left hand side. Whereas the right side, x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma, we need to multiply. Okay, so if you are comfortable with the multiplication, x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma into x plus alpha beta, beta gamma, gamma alpha into x square minus alpha beta gamma. So now both sides we have a cubic equation. We need to compare the coefficients. Coefficient of x cube is 1 on both sides. Then the coefficient of x square, here it is b by a, there it is minus of alpha plus beta plus gamma. When you compare the coefficient of x square, alpha plus beta plus gamma is minus b by a. And then compare the coefficient of x, here it is c by a, and this is, so just a minute, this is x square and that is x. Okay, yeah. Now coefficient of x, here the coefficient is c by here, and there it is alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha. So compare the coefficients. How it will become? Alpha, beta plus beta, gamma plus gamma, alpha is equals to c by a. Is it right? And then constant. So alpha, beta, gamma is equals to minus d by a, because minus is there. See, you need to observe the pattern how this sum of roots, product of roots, sum of roots taken two at a time are happening. Alternative plus and minus signs will come actually. Okay, you just observe minus, plus and minus, and every always we are dividing with a. See, the denominator is the coefficient of x cube actually, right? See, this alpha plus beta plus gamma is equals to minus b by a, and this is termed as sum of roots. We know it, right? Sum of roots. And this alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha, and that is c by a, which is termed as sum of products of roots taken to, sum of products of roots taken to. See, at a time we need to take two roots and then product them, at the end add all those products, okay? And alpha, beta is equals to d minus d by a, which is simply product of roots. Product of roots, sum of roots, sum of products of roots and product of roots. As I said, and as a notation, the sum of roots is considered as S1, whereas sum of products of roots taken two at a time, it is considered as S2, and product of the roots, all the three roots at a time we are multiplying, so this is treated as S3 as a notation, and some books and some persons will notate like that, S1, S2, S3, okay? Have a look. So at the end, this is discussion related to the cubic equation and their roots. And then I will discuss for fourth degree equation. Afterwards, we need to extend it for nth degree. Next, see if alpha, beta, gamma, delta are roots of fourth degree equation ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e is equals to 0. Then we will say that these are the zeros of the polynomial, and then we have a chance to rewrite. So at the end, what we have is x power 4 plus b by a x cube plus c by a x square plus d by a x plus e by a is equals to x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma into x minus delta. And now we need to multiply these four. After that, we need to establish relation between roots and coefficients. So from there it is very clear that alpha plus beta plus gamma plus delta is equals to minus b by a. When you multiply all these things, we will get it, okay? And in the same way, product of roots taken two at a time, alpha, beta plus alpha, gamma plus alpha, delta plus beta, gamma plus beta, delta plus gamma, delta, and this is equals to c by a. And then taken three at a time, alpha, beta, gamma plus beta, gamma, delta plus gamma, delta, alpha plus delta, alpha, beta is equals to minus d by a. And the product of the roots, alpha, beta, gamma, delta is equals to e by a. You need to observe that alternate plus minus signs will come, okay? B by a, C by a, D by a, E by a, with alternate plus and minus signs, okay? And as we mentioned, this is what? Sum of roots. And this is what? Sum of products of roots taken to and this is what? Sum of products of roots taken 3. And this is product of roots. So as I mentioned, there is a separate notation, and this is S1, sum of the roots. This is S2, sum of the products taken 2. S3, sum of the products taken 3. S4, sum of the products taken 4. See, first of all, just observe this alpha plus beta plus gamma. That is very clear. Since we have 4, you need to add all those things. And then observe this. Alpha, beta plus alpha, gamma plus alpha, delta, beta, gamma, beta, delta, gamma, delta. We need to write all possible pairs, okay? Actual roots are alpha, beta, gamma, delta, right? Alpha into beta. One possible product of 2, alpha, gamma. Other possible product, alpha, delta. Third possible product. So alpha is clear. Then start with beta. Beta, gamma, beta, delta. Two products with beta, then comma delta, that is the sixth product. So totally there are six terms, okay? Six terms are there totally if you consider any two out of these four. And if you add all those things, it is termed as sum of the products of roots taken 2, and its value is C by A. In the same way, this is sum of the products of roots taken 3. So there are four numbers, alpha, beta, gamma, delta. From those four members, every time you need to take three numbers, multiply them. So since every time we are taking three, that indicates that every time we are leaving one. So once leave alpha, once leave beta, once leave gamma, once leave delta. Every time you have three numbers, multiply them. And this is the sum of the products taken 3 at a time, which is minus d by a. So at the end, sum of the products taken 4. Sum of the products taken 4 in the sense, since there are only 4, so there is only one possible term with the four numbers. So sum of the products taken 4 at a time, or product of the roots, is alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Okay. So S1, S2, S3, S4. S1, sum of the products taken 1 at a time. Taken 1 at a time. At a time you need to take one root. Okay. Since there are alpha, beta, gamma, delta, at a time take one alpha. Okay. Then take another one beta. Okay. So that is S1. S2, sum of the products taken 2 at a time. At a time you need to take two numbers out of those alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Take any two, alpha, beta. Okay, that's a combination. Then again, see, throw in it and then take another two numbers. So at the end, these are all possible pairs taken 2 from the 4. These are all possible pairs taken 3 out of 4. These are all possible pairs taken 4 out of 4. So these are the values at the end. Okay. So the relation between the roots is simply sum of the roots is minus b by a, sum taken 2 at a time is minus c by a, and this is minus d by a, this is e by a. So we discussed it for quadratic, cubic and fourth degree. Now I generalize it for a polynomial of nth degree. Okay, have a look. Next, for nth degree polynomial, so for example, this is a polynomial equation of nth degree, okay? And for that polynomial equation, we have n roots. This alpha 1, alpha 2 and so on, alpha n are the roots of this polynomial. Since they are the roots, as we discussed, sum of roots is S1, which is minus an minus 1 by an. Or you may write it like this, that is equals to minus coefficient of x power n minus 1 divided by coefficient of x power n. Okay, so minus an minus 1 by an. And the next thing is S2, sum of products taken 2. We need to write sum of all the products taken 2. So what are the possible products? Many products are possible. Alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 1, alpha 3, alpha 1, alpha 4, up to alpha 1, alpha n. So with alpha it is clear. Then start with alpha 2. Alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 2, alpha 4, up to alpha 2, alpha n. If it is clear, then start with alpha 3. Like that, you need to list out all the possible products, okay? And taken 2 at a time. So if you add all those products taken 2 at a time, then the value is what? An minus 2 by An. So that An minus 2 by An also can be written as this is equals to coefficient of x power n minus 2 divided by coefficient of x power n. The same way we need to extend it. If you need S3, sum of the products taken 3, then that answer is minus coefficient of x power n minus 3 by coefficient of x power n. So S1, S2, S3 and so on we need to extend. At the end I have Sn is equals to product of the roots. So all the numbers we need to multiply and this is the answer. So this can be written as minus 1 to the power n. We don't know about n, right? Whether it is even or odd. Okay. So if 1 is odd, so we are having minus 1. If 2 is even, so we just having plus sign here. What about n? We don't know, right? So that's why you need to consider minus 1 to the power n into a0 is the constant term divided by an is the coefficient of x power n. So at the end, this is the relation between the roots and the coefficients of the polynomial and very helpful in many cases. Okay, have a look.